Enjoyed those sounds? Well, then let's talk about sound today. Zoom in! Sound is a wave or vibration that travels through three states of matter: solid, liquid, and gas. And of course, it is something that can be heard. But have you ever wondered, how does sound travel? It's simple. It all starts with a mechanical movement, like pouring hot chocolate in a mug, clapping your hands, or hitting a gong. So, when you hit a gong, there's a movement which causes some vibrations in the molecules, which in turn causes the other molecules around them to vibrate. And these vibrations from one molecule to the other help sound to travel. You couldn't hear me, right? Well, because I was in vacuum. In spaces where there is just vacuum and no matter, sound will not travel because there won't be any molecules to vibrate. Frequency is an important measure of sound. When there are more number of sound waves passing through a fixed place at a given time, it means that the frequency is high. When the number of waves become less, we hear low frequency sound waves. The human ear is capable of detecting frequencies between 20 Hz to 20,000 Hz. Any frequency above or below that is inaudible to the human ear. Higher frequency sound waves will give us a higher pitch. Take a guitar and play the heaviest string. Hearing the buzz? Now, play the thinner string. Isn't there a difference in sound? Well, that's the difference in pitch. The loudness of sound is measured in volume. And to quantify volume, we use decibels. Here is an example of volume. Can you hear me now? Trivia time! Sound waves can bend around corners and obstacles. Any sound with a frequency below 20 Hz is called infrasound, and any sound with a frequency above 20,000 Hz is known as ultrasound. So, this is me zooming out. Tune in next time for more fun facts.